I'm here with Greg Wood, punter for the football team, team MVP last year. Greg's going to teach me a little bit how to do a little kicking, a little punting. Greg, what's the most important thing to remember when kicking?
Well, I guess in general, the most important thing is just to hit the ball with your foot.
Yeah, thanks, man. Like, do you point your toe? What do you do here?
Well, to get a little technical, of course, you have to point your toe. You have to drop the ball a certain way, and the first thing you got to do is catch it. So.
All right, well, let's see this. Let's see this how it goes. We got a few balls here.
All right.
Give me the pointers right here.
First thing you should do is probably stretch. It's the most important thing about kicking.
I'm limbered up.
All right. From there, just try and hold the ball out, drop it flat, and just kick it.
All right.
Not to get too tight.
What about this rugby-style stuff I see? You ever try that?
I'm not a big fan of it. Yeah. That's more just run to the right and see what you can do.
Yeah.
That's a little more your style. For me, I like to do a little more pro, so here we go.
All right, let's see it.
It's pretty good. I'll take that.
I'll take that, too. All right, let me see this. Let me see how we do this here. How's spring ball been so far? Actually, critique me first.
Then okay.
Straight drop. Points up. All right.
Exactly. Well, you know, John.
That's all right. It's like a knuckleball, though.
It wasn't that bad, to be honest.
It's like a knuckleball, though. How do you kick it like a spiral?
Luck, for the most part.
Luck.
No, it all comes down to the drop. You just got to be able to drop it perfectly, but that takes years of practice and time.
All right. Let's see you kick another one.
All right.
So how's the football?
Very good so far.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. I've been enjoying. We have a new formation, a new coach, Coach Bowers, and I've been starting to like him a little more each day.
Yeah.
So.
How are we punting now? I know like a couple years back we had like the big splits.
Well, that's what we're doing now again. We're splitting everybody out, having three big old guys in front of me like Boz and Blair. And
Boz and Blair.
Hoping they can stop anyone coming from near me.
Oh, that's funny.
All right, for the next important thing, lick your hands. Get a good grip on the ball.
Is that catching it?
Yeah, especially with Ferdy, who snaps it pretty fast, pretty high, so.
All
right, that much farther.
All right, so, do you have any tackles left here? I think I remember.
I've had somewhere around six, but only two were recorded.
Hey, I didn't have any, and I got credit for one. Oh, that was ugly. I kicked that one with my shin.
See, you gotta kick the ball with your foot. That's the most important part.
All right, I think we got a couple more balls around here. Let me toss you one. I remember last year you, made a tackle and I think you got hurt.
I did. Spent a night in the hospital getting a cast on for a bruised kidney.
That's rough stuff, man.
There's a lot of guys bigger than me playing nowadays.
Yeah. Oh, man, that was pretty good. All right.
That's not much better, though.
As I kick another ball, Wood, have you ever played soccer or anything? Like, how'd you get involved in kicking? Have you been playing any other position ever?
I used to play tight end in high school, but I wasn't too good at that. But I've actually never played soccer in my entire life.
Really?
I've never kicked a soccer ball in my entire life.
You never kicked a soccer ball?
No. When I was about 8 years old, my father, when he was younger, he was in the punt pass kick competition for the NFL.
Uh-huh.
So when I was about 8 years old, he built a field goal post in our backyard, and I've been kicking since then.
That's a good story.
I know.
When you make it big someday, you can tell that's all the ESPNs.
Give my dad some FaceTime on ESPN?
Yeah, there you go.
That's his biggest dream.
So what's the difference in the shoes? Like, I'm a lineman. I have big, bulky spikes. You got these.
I use, rubber bottoms for one, but I use soccer cleats, oddly enough, not playing soccer. Because they're the thinnest kind of shoe, and the more contact you have with the ball, the better. That wasn't too bad.
I think I'm coming back to me. I don't think it went anywhere.
It's a good 2-yard punch, huh?
Yeah, man.
Hey, if they need you.
What about hang time? I hear this hang time stat all the time.
Well, that's probably the most important part.
That's the most important part.
I mean, you can kick it.
What's good hang time?
Well, I guess for our level, college level, about 4.5. 4.2, 4.5.
What do you get?
About 4.6.
Ah, there you go.
NFL guys are more around 5.0, but they also kick it farther and higher. So there's a lot of things there.
Think you could hit that scoreboard in Dallas?
Oh, of course. Many people don't know, but that's actually pretty easy to do.
Is it?
Those people who designed that aren't very smart.
Spend billion dollars on a stadium. And,
need some valve engineers.
I'm embarrassing myself. This is bad.
Don't pull a muscle.
Yeah. All right, Greg. Well, you got me pretty good. What was my biggest problem? I know I had a lot.
Well, I guess there's a lot there, to be honest. But your first one is flexibility. I recommend stretching.
Come on, I used to do Irish dance. Man.
That was pretty good. You didn't do that while you were kicking. Probably stretch 3 to 4 hours a day for about 2 years, and you'll get there. I would recommend dropping the ball a little better.
I thought you were going to say drop a few LBs.
No, I won't be that.
Thanks, man.
It doesn't mean you've seen some of the punters in the NFL. Some big guys. You got powerful enough legs. You just got to drop the ball right, and not to get too scientific, but if you keep it about 11 o'clock, drop it about waist high, with a little less wind out here, you might be able to kick it pretty far.
See Chris teach you that or Coach Gray?
A little of both.
All right. Well, thanks for coming on,
You're welcome. You're welcome. To be honest, pretty well for a guy of his size, not to be too mean to him. He does have some flexibility, so I think if he just toned it up a little bit, put some time into it, he could probably be pretty good.
All right. Well, I am a horrible kicker. I learned this today. Greg is a good kicker. I knew that already. But I had fun with all three guys. It was definitely a good time. I learned a lot that I didn't already know about football. All I knew was block, and now I know how to run routes, drop back, throw, and kick the ball. Well, I'm not good at any of them, but I know how to do it at least.
Oh, of course. Maybe not a punter, but definitely one of my picks.
My favorite was throwing because I was better than Malantis at the post.